सात बार के विधानसभा सदस्य हैं। उत्तर प्रदेश विधानसभा के वरिष्ठतम विधायकों में से एक माननीय मंत्री जी, राजघराने से आते हैं। उत्तर प्रदेश के सिद्धार्थनगर जनपद की बासी रियासत के वर्तमान में राजा भी हैं। माननीय मंत्री जी ने अजमेर के मायो कॉलेज से अपनी पढ़ाई की, इसके बाद केसी कॉलेज बॉम्बे से बीए ऑनर्स करके राजनीति में कदम रखा और स्वास्थ्य मंत्रालय से पहले उत्तर प्रदेश के मुख्यमंत्री श्री योगी आदित्यनाथ जी ने इनको एक्साइज मंत्रालय की जिम्मेदारी दी थी, जिसका बखूबी इन्होंने निर्वहन किया। मैं चाहूँगा एक बार जोरदार तालियों के साथ उत्तर प्रदेश के स्वास्थ्य एवं परिवार कल्याण मंत्री श्री जय प्रताप सिंह जी का स्वागत करें। ओवर टू यू सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, एक्सेलेंसीज ऑफ वेरियस कंट्रीज वर सिटिंग ऑन द डायस। मैं एक बार जरूर कहना चाहूँगा कि व्यक्ति का बैकग्राउंड उतना ज़्यादा मायने नहीं रखता है जितना कि जिस डाइट पर वो खड़ा है उसको कितनी जिम्मेदारी से वो आगे बढ़ाता है। अभी हमारे संचालक महोदय गुप्ता जी ने कुछ शब्दों मेरे बारे में कहा, तो आई डोंट थिंक दैट इज़ वेरी रेलिवेंट टू द फैक्ट दैट हाउ यू डू योर वर्क इन टूडेज वर्ल्ड इन ए डिफिकल्ट सिचुएशन। सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट आई लाइक टू स्टार्ट विद अ फ्यू वर्ड्स कि अभी आई ऑल्टरनेट बिटवीन हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश। अभी हमारे बीच में महामहिम जगदीश्वर गोवर्धन जी, उच्च आयुक्त मॉरिशस गणराज के, ने अपना उद्बोधन दिया, तो मुझे लगा कि जैसे कि हम लोग उत्तर प्रदेश में जब अपना भाषण वाषण देते हैं उसी तरह का आपने भी बड़ा अच्छा भाषण दिया। पता चला कि आप मूलतः माने जहाँ का उनका परिवार निकल के गया था वो आज़मगढ़ का था, हम लोग के ज़िले से बहुत ज़्यादा दूर भी नहीं है, और उनके प्राइम मिनिस्टर भी वहीं के हैं आज़मगढ़ के। और जिन विषयों पर आपने बात चर्चा की वो बहुत अच्छा लगा, क्योंकि आपने सुभाष पालेकर जैसे नाम का आपने अभी आपके सामने कहा, शायद बहुत सारे लोग को इसके जानकारी कम ही होगा, क्योंकि जब हम इनोवेटिव टेक्नोलॉजी में काम कर रहे हैं, साइंटिफिक टेक्नोलॉजी में काम कर रहे हैं और हम शहरों में रहते हैं, तो जो किसान से जुड़े हुए समस्या जिसको आज हम सब परेशान हैं उसको इनोवेट करना या उसको परिवर्तन करके एक सुरक्षित खाद्य पदार्थ बनाने के लिए सुभाष पालेकर जैसा नाम पूरे देश में चर्चित है कि वो कैसे ऑर्गेनिक खेती करने के लिए हम सब किसानों को प्रोत्साहित दोबारा कर रहे हैं ताकि हमारा हेल्थ केयर वहीं से ठीक होने लगे। सो इट इज़ अ बिग सरप्राइज ऑल्सो एंड इट इज़ वेरी नाइस टू हियर फ्रॉम अ डिफरेंट कंट्री अबाउट आर पीपल ओवर हियर इन दिस कंट्री and that is where the problem in this country lies also, and I will relate it more to UP where we have a population of 23 crores or as somebody said 230 million, a sizable amount of population equal to a lot of countries in the world and possibly more also. So in its way, in its own way, we are a country of our own. We have 60% of our population which is dependent on agriculture, they live in the villages, and with very little accessibility to good health care, which is what we are trying to manage in Uttar Pradesh. Now when you have a state like Uttar Pradesh which has been not very well managed over the last 20 years administratively and technically to improve the state of the health, when we come into a political situation like this, as we've come in the last 2.5 years, it becomes a very difficult change to be made, especially for the bureaucracy which works with us, for the people under the bureaucracy, and to make them change according to our thinking. This is what happens in the country also. And since you are from all parts of the country, You are into all lot of technology for health. So it makes a lot of difference on the policies which are put up by the government of India or by different states, based on which you do your businesses also. So today, Uttar Pradesh, which has 75 districts in our state, and so we have about 175 districts hospitals. I'm just giving a little bit of a figures on how we take care of our health system. And below our district hospitals, we have community health centers, which are about 853. And below that, we have primary health centers, which are about 3,621. And the sub-centers we have, which is related to villages of a population about, say, 2,000 to 3,000 or 4,000, that is about 20,521. Now, with this structure in place over the number of years, we try and provide healthcare to the poorest of the poor in the villages who come to our centers in looking for cheap healthcare services and to ensure that he is able to live his life properly. Over the years, the service of the doctors to be given to the patients have deteriorated for a number of reasons. There is no point going into something like that because it is on an all India basis. But to ensure that every citizen of UP who comes to our health centers is given good healthcare services is a very difficult task when the doctors who are involved in this have come to a stage where they're not being able to either what they have read in their colleges as an MBBS student, what specialization they've done, they've not been able to impart that particular knowledge down to the patients who require that knowledge. Now in UP, over the last 2.5 years, we give free medical services to this entire population. We give them free CT scan, MRI, hemodialysis, ultrasound, digital x-rays, cheap medicine, as what the Excellency Ambassador from Argentina also said, where they buy 1% of medicine from India, generic medicine. Ever since this government in 2014, when it came into the center, we have tried to emphasize and ensure that cheap generic medicines are sold on the same compositions or the formulations as what a medicine is manufactured in very high-tech, by high-tech companies like Glaxo and Cipla in other countries. The same composition, the same formulation is given in a cheaper way, not branded, but it has the same effect on the human body as any branded medicine would be given. So today when you have what we call is Jan Aushadhya Kendra. These are centers, medical shops, which are opened in the district hospital, in major big hospitals in the state and all over the country, which impart or which give cheap medicine, good quality cheap medicine to the patients who come out from these hospitals and they want to buy medicine from the shops. That is to ensure that the shops which sell expensive medicine is curtailed, good quality hospitals are given by these centers. And of course, along with that, in a state like UP, when we formed a medical corporation which centrally buys and purchases all the medicine and distributes it to every district and to every district hospital and to every community health center and to every primary center in such a huge manner, we ensure that those cheap medicines are given to the lowest centers of ours where it is given to the patients over there. Now, within this entire system which we have, also in a country like India where you have a huge structure of national highways coming up in a very big way and in a very fast way. When you come up as national highways, you also have the number of population which is going up, the number of cars and vehicles which are going up at very high speed, so you have a lot of accidents. Accidents are happening at a very fast pace, and so UP has, in tune with the national policy, We have started opening trauma centers almost in every 50 to 100 kilometers on the national highways all across UP. And to man those trauma centers, we have a structure of 102 and 108 ambulances, emergency services, which are run like in other states also. Like we have a huge state where we have 2,200 ambulances of both the numbers, which are running equally, alternately, all over the countryside, all over the village line, and with ALS ambulances also, which are available in UP at every level. Our problem is what that while we are into the mode of trying to technically go into a lot of innovations, and I came across in Lucknow, there was a seminar very recently on vitreo retinotherapy, which is where you have your eye surgeons. I think if there are some people here who understand that. I met Dr. Balram Bhargav, who is the director of ICSR also, who heads the thing. And there are 15 startups which have come up on medical lines in India, which are giving cheap options of different types of startups, different types of technology, which will come useful to people like us in UP or to any other state, where they can improve the system of giving cheap healthcare and good healthcare right down to the village level. So you have things like telemedicine, which is now coming into our thing in a very big way. We are ensuring that telemedicine comes in, and through that we can access good doctors right up to Delhi or Bombay or anywhere, wherever the slots are given. So that is one of the things which we are incorporating into rural areas where we have a problem of doctors. Now again, on the same side, I would like to say that we have a shortage of about 7,000 doctors today. According to the 2001 population details, I mean, I'm going back a little earlier, we require 18,000 doctors, out of which today we have only about 12,000 doctors or 11,700 doctors, something like that. But if we go by the 2011 census and by the WHO records, then we should be having 36,000 doctors, which is not a possibility in a country like India, where everybody, doctors who come out of medical colleges, are mostly getting involved into the private sector, which is also very large. Now for that, UP has also gone into ensuring that we have our own doctors by opening 29 medical colleges in a span of 2.5 years, where already 11 medical colleges have started the first year MBBS courses. The others are under construction, and by 2022 we will have full 29 medical colleges which have been coming up now by 2022 in 5 years, and plus 13 medical colleges which are already running earlier. With that, it will ensure us to get at least 3 lakh doctors every year at different levels, where we can at least ensure that they come into our service, into our government service, and help us in giving us good healthcare facility to the people in our state. So while we have all these problems which we are battling, at the same time we are looking at different types of technology, upgradations, different type of housekeeping instances where people come to us at every level wanting to introduce their product, in ensuring that our hospitals are clean, disinfected, and different type of technologies where you can also look at where you have cancer patients, where you have diabetes, which is one of the, I think now India is one of the major cause of concern, which has created a lot of complications in the human body when you have diabetes, and if you are not careful about it, your kidneys are affected, your heart is affected, and everything goes wrong, and so you are totally in a state of medical line all the time towards the end of your life. So these are problems which UP face, and we have geared up to face them in the last 2.5 years. We have made a lot of innovative changes, and we are making more changes as we go by and as what our budget helps us to create. Now when we talk about the budget, And it was mentioned just now, in a country like India, which is a developing country, when we have 130 million or whatever, 130 crores of people in a huge population all over India, the ideal GDP ratio should be 8%. But at the moment, we are down to about 1.3%, which also the government feels, because in a country like India, when suddenly you have changed pattern from what you were working in the last 50, 60 years, and suddenly you have changed your, you prioritize your other items in such a way that you are spending more on the social sector, so you need to spend a lot more on the health system also. So today in UP, when I put up my budget, I am strongly of the nature that if not 8%, which is of course a little too much for our state also, but at least to the tune of 4%, I'm going to advocate that we allocate our budget of 4% to the health sector, so that I'm able to at least ensure that our people at the ground level are able to get good healthcare services. And with the coming influx of the doctors which will be coming in, we should be able to manage in the next 5 to 7 years of getting a good system going in UP itself. So, I think this platform has given me an opportunity to showcase my, I think my junior minister had also come yesterday. He was here, no? हमारे जो राज्य मंत्री हैं श्री अतुल गर्ग जी वो भी आए थे यहाँ पर और उन्होंने भी अपने भाषण में कुछ बातें कही होगी मैं उसी सब से जोड़ते हुए मैं आप लोग से भी अनुरोध करूँगा कि आप लोग ने भी अपना इस प्लेटफॉर्म के जरिए अपने बहुत सारे ये नए नए अप्लायंसेस या अपने सिस्टम्स को डेवलप किया है जो हमारे हेल्थ केयर सिस्टम में आवश्यक होगी पर मैंने ये भी देखा है कि आपके जो सिस्टम जो अभी मैंने थोड़े स्टॉल्स भी देखे थे बहुत ज़्यादा जो बने भी हैं तो वो ज़्यादा करके शहरों के लिए बड़े प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल्स के लिए जिनके पास अच्छी खासी बजट रहती है उनके लिए तो अच्छा रहता है परंतु हमारे जैसे प्रदेश में उत्तर प्रदेश में जब हम स्ट्रगल करके आ रहे हैं नीचे से हम उन उपकरणों को कितना अपने सिस्टम में लागू कर पाएंगे कैसे उसको कर पाएंगे कितना हमारे लिए कॉस्टिंग उसको निर्भर करेगा और उसका उद्देश्य और उसका असर क्या होगा हमारे हॉस्पिटल्स में वो हमको देखने की आवश्यकता है तो मैं जितने लोग भी आते हैं हमारे पास और जैसे जो डायरेक्टर ICSR के जो डॉक्टर बलराम भार्गव जो पद्मश्री भी हैं उन्होंने मुझे कहा था कि 15 ऐसे स्टार्टअप्स हैं टेक्नोलॉजी के जो हेल्थ केयर से जुड़े हुए हैं जो धीरे धीरे करके आपके उत्तर प्रदेश और बिहार जैसे राज्यों में अपना प्रोडक्ट को शोकेस करेंगे वो आपसे जुड़ेंगे तो वो आपको बहुत ज़्यादा फ़ायदेमंद भी होगा बहुत महंगा नहीं पड़ेगा क्योंकि हमारा स्ट्रक्चर इतना बड़ा है और इतने बड़े स्ट्रक्चर के लिए कोई भी कंपनी अगर आएगी तो उसको बहुत सोच समझ के भी आना पड़ेगा और बहुत बड़े काम पैमाने पर काम भी करना पड़ेगा तो हम स्वागत करते हैं सभी लोग को कि उत्तर प्रदेश में आप आए हम लोग पूरे खुले मन से आपका स्वागत भी करेंगे हर एक उपकरण को हम देखना भी चाहते हैं समझना भी चाहते हैं जो हमारे नीचे के सिस्टम तक काम आए और हमको जिससे हम अपने जनसंख्या को अच्छी दवा दे पाएँ इसके लिए हम आप सबका स्वागत करेंगे मैं यहाँ के संचालक महोदय से और यहाँ के जो जिन्होंने ये प्रोग्राम को तय किया था और अनुरोध किया था उत्तर प्रदेश सरकार को कि स्वास्थ्य मंत्री के रूप में मुझे भेजने के लिए मैं आप सभी लोग को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देता हूँ कि आपने मुझे यहाँ बोलने का एक अवसर दिया और अपनी बात रखने के लिए मैं आपको पुनः धन्यवाद देता हूँ बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद